Headshot. What's good, everybody? So, we're in the kitchen today, going to do a little cooking. This is a really super simple recipe, something you can make in probably less than, I'd say, 45 minutes. And it's pretty good, pretty macro friendly, especially using the ingredients that I do. And just about the easiest one I make. So, let's get started. So we got our chicken breast here. Got five of them laid out. I did not actually weigh them, but they're about 6 to 7 ounces a piece. No big deal. Got ourselves some rice. This is 550 grams. That's roughly a cup of rice per serving for 5 days. We got our water measured out and everything. Got ourselves a nice Pyrex pan here. Some Campbell's cream of mushroom soup, 98% fat free. Pretty macro friendly. Nothing dramatically horrible about it. Honestly, if you're that worried about it, it's like 30 calories per serving, so I don't think you'll die. Anyway, so basically what you do is you trim up your chicken and you throw it in the pan. I've already got this done, as you can see, just nice and trimmed up. We're going to throw it in that there pan. We're going to take the cream of mushroom soup and we're going to throw it on top. So I will do that and show you exactly what it looks like when I'm finished. All right. Now we got that all set up. We got the cream of mushroom soup in there. What I did was I took the can, voila, and I just emptied it out on top and kind of smeared it around. Honestly, that's not bad at all. That's going to be fine. What'll happen is that'll bake, and then all the juices from the chicken and stuff like that'll thin it out and kind of make like a gravy, and it makes a cream of mushroom soup gravy. It's kind of good. We also have a second can of cream of mushroom soup. I'm going to use that after the fact to kind of give me a nice thick sauce on top. With it being so low calorie and low fat, it's not bad, and it adds a lot of flavor. Plus, it gives something for the rice to kind of stick to and everything after, because we're going to do this as separate dishes. So that way, if you take it with you to lunch or whatever, it's going to be good. The recipe I found actually calls for putting the rice in the pan. I tried that. It sucked. It made the rice real mushy. So we're going to do it this way, and it will work out great. So bear with me. And oh, and one other thing. We're going to cover this with aluminum foil, just to keep it all sealed in. I haven't done that yet, but I'm pretty sure you can get the idea. So I'm gonna get this covered, get the oven preheated, and get everything ready. I will catch you guys probably after the finished product. All right, so it's done. We cooked this on 400 degrees for about, I'd say 40 minutes, maybe 50 minutes. It takes a little bit longer when you put the soup on the top of it. I'm not 100% sure why, but it does. Anyway, we have a finished product. That is still in the pan. There's our rice. So what we're going to do is we're going to start laying this stuff out. I'll show you what I'm going to do, and pretty much that'll be it. This is a very basic recipe. All right, time to start divvying everything out, and I'll show you exactly what's going to happen here. So, got our Tupperware here. I'm gonna take a chicken breast, toss that in there. Got myself a little cup here. This works out pretty good for measuring out my rice. So, I'm gonna take that. Nice cup full of rice, dump on top. Little spoon. Soup. Take a little spoon of soup, kind of just toss it on top there. Don't flick it everywhere. Maybe another one. And there you go. That's pretty much all you got to do. Maybe stir it up a little bit if you want. Then you can microwave that and it'll be ready to go.
So, that's pretty much the recipe. Cream of mushroom soup, rice, and chicken. Doesn't get more basic than that. Make sure you get the 98% fat-free, otherwise you're going to be adding a bunch of calories you don't need, unless you need those calories because you're bulking or something weird like that. Otherwise, I'd stick to the 98% fat-free because, well, it's a cream-based soup and that's what you're going to get is fat. other than that, it works pretty well. I have tried this before. You can add plus or minus on the extra soup if you want. Maybe none at all. That's up to you. I like it because when you microwave it or when you heat it back up, it keeps the rice nice and moist and gives it something to, like, not harden and taste like crap. So, take that. Hope you enjoyed it. Hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, like it, subscribe, all that good stuff. Yes, I'm leaving that in. And, as always, until next time. I could take the pitchfork from the devil, keep a super suit like I'm incredible, from the deep blue sea to the dark blue sky. A crocodile by his tail, handcuff the judge and throw the cops in jail, make the meanest woman break down and cry. My name 3 times and you knock on wood. Candyman hooks, I terrorize your hood. Flashing Macs on the cop the way a gangster should. I snatch food from the mouth of a tiger. Take a gasoline bath and I walk through fire. Bear hug a grizzly, suck milk from a titty. Take the sergeant hat from his head and use it for a frisbee. Spit in the crocodile face, have a menage a trois with 2 female apes. Then sleep in the barrel of butcher knives. I drink honey straight from the beehive. Bungee jumping off the Empire State, butt naked. Rollerblading across the Golden Gate, butt naked. With the baddest man alive and I don't plan to die. When the grim reaper come, I look her right in his eye. I bust up in the face of the witch of the east. Tell a great white shark to go and brush his teeth. I'm the man who stole the golden fleece, and I date rape beauty right in front of the beast. The baddest man alive, and I don't plan to die. Come on, tell somebody. I'm the baddest man alive.